Hey, I didn't intend on doing a video about zebras on Sony cameras, but here we are. I've recently came across a lot of mistakes being made by new filmmakers, especially when they set up their zebras to specific RE values, like 41 on SLOG3, which represents middle gray. And they set up everything, their frame, lighting, and just start recording, and then they come home with either under or overexposed footage. What they don't know though is that when they set their zebras, they most likely set them with a LUT applied or with the standard Rec 709 conversion LUT by Sony, which is built in the camera. However, those values don't correspond to the SLOG3 values, which I will demonstrate right now. So we are in SLOG3 on CNEI, gamma assist is off, and we're setting middle gray, which is right here at 41. We're nailing it. Be aware though that I'm just filming with natural light right now, so this is no scientific test, but I will be quick enough to show you that the zebras are not accurate when using a LUT, which I will enable here. Standard Rec 709, and you see that the zebra is disappearing from middle gray patch. So this is a clear indicator that the zebras don't compensate or adjust when using a different LUT. It's worth noting though that on older Sony cameras I've used, back when we were only able to use picture profiles, and you could set up the gamma assist. In most cases, the gamma assist accounted for the changing viewing experience. So that's not the case if you're in CNEI, at least on the FX30. It's also not the case when you're in flexible ISO, because you cannot toggle the gamma assist. And in essence, that's also not what you want to do, because gamma assist has been designed to accommodate for HDR viewing environments, so that the contrast will be boosted. That's actually not what you want to do with a LOG recording. So you should stick to applying a LUT. What I would suggest you do is testing your camera. So you set up your zebras, just like so. I have my set mine to the standard range on C1, which is 41 plus minus 1. This is corresponding to middle gray. And just do the simple test that you go to your LUTs and you change from SLOG3 to Rec 709, and if those zebras are moving to different patches, you will see that they don't compensate. So when you're depending on zebras during filming, I would suggest you set them up with the regular SLOG3 viewer without applying any LUT, so you're on the safe side. And my recommendation is that you use 41 for middle gray. And when it comes to highlights, I've set mine to 92 plus. To be safe, I would suggest using 88. However, keep in mind that when you color your highlights and post-processing, no one will point out that you are clipping highlights, at least not if there's color information available on the highlight. If it's pure white and you're not considering grading it in post, then people will notice. Yeah, that's just my 2 cents on how to properly expose using zebras. But I would always rely on using either waveforms, force color, or the EL zone system, which will get you in the ballpark much quicker and will guarantee that your end result will be satisfying. So see you in the next one.